A whistleblower complaint is making major news, and presidential candidate Elizabeth Warren is appearing to broaden her base while Senator Bernie Sanders is trying a new approach.
Joining us to dig into all of this is the Hill's editor-in-chief, Bob Cusack. He's here with the debrief.
Hey, Bob.
Good morning.
Great to see you.
Happy Friday.
All right, this whistleblower thing.
Yeah.
Just first, bring us up to speed. And Rudy Giuliani had a crazy appearance with Chris Cuomo last night. And it appears this is about the president's conversations with Ukraine vis-a-vis Joe Biden.
Right.
What is the reporting at this point
say? Well, there's a lot we don't know.
Okay.
We don't know who the whistleblower is. But it appears that it would be someone at a high level. Okay.
Yeah.
So at first, we knew that this whistleblower had filed this complaint, which has been deemed credible by the Inspector General of the Intelligence Community, and who briefed Congress but didn't reveal all the information. Now we know, or it's been reported, that it deals with Ukraine. And of course, Ukraine is a controversy for the Biden family, because when Biden was vice president, his son, Hunter, was involved and paid for by an energy company in Ukraine. There was a conflict of interest, which government watchdogs have criticized Joe Biden for. So Giuliani on CNN last night said,
for 28 minutes
yes,
in this interview.
Yes, it was quite a thing, where he said, initially said he didn't ask for the authorities to look into it, and then did. Now, on the other hand, this is another situation where Democrats, I think, we've got President Trump, we've got him, and this is gonna end President Trump, and they've said that many times before. So there's a lot we don't know. The investigation's ongoing, but this seems to be a serious thing.
Yeah.
So there are some constitutional issues here, right, between what Congress has the right to know and what's the purview of the executive. I mean, could you elucidate some of those a little bit more? You know, what are the two views of the executive and Congress and the powers, and what's the battle between these two branches?
Oh, and it's an ongoing theme, of course, that we've seen of oversight, especially in this administration. And of course, every administration doesn't like to answer questions from Congress, especially a Congress that is run by, and then the House is run by, the opposition party. So Democrats are saying, listen, we need to know, we deserve to know the details of this situation. But the administration says, no, you're not. And so here we are again, stuck. And, you know, a lot of these things, whether they're disputes on this or other matters, where do they end up? They end up in the courts. Now, this investigation will go ongoing. But I do think that, of course, the president's saying, I didn't do anything. His allies say he's always, other people are around him when he's talking to foreign leaders, which for the most part I think is true, but not all the time. So it's a big issue.
Yeah. Some other reporting from The Hill about Senator Sanders' campaign. So, of course, we actually talked today to the head of the Working Families Party. They threw their support behind Elizabeth Warren after having endorsed Sanders back in 2016. The two of them are basically tied for second right now in the Democratic race. And there's been some reporting around some staff shakeups in the Sanders campaign and sort of moving things to try to gain more momentum at this time. What are you all learning?
Well, we're reporting that Sanders is reshuffling some of his staff in the early states in Iowa and New Hampshire. They are concerned. We've talked to some Sanders allies on background, and they see a rising Warren. She is rising in the polls. She's doing better with African Americans. Now, she's nowhere near Joe Biden's, but you remember, Sanders and Warren have been allies. They haven't gone after one another. And who's rising and who's stuck? Warren is rising and Sanders appears stuck. I think that, you know, that Sanders is going to have to mix things up of how he runs his campaign. He ran a very successful campaign in 2016. The situation is very different. He's running the same type of campaign here. At first, he was talking more about his personal story, which I thought was a good move. He's really moved away from that and really just gone back to the script of 2016. I think he's got to mix it up a little bit.
Interesting.
In 2016, we saw Sanders back away from criticizing Hillary at all. He didn't bring up the emails, he said repeatedly. And then towards the end, when it became a pretty close race, you know, he started to actually hit Hillary with some of the attacks that were out there in the media or on the right. Do you think that Sanders is going to have to start attacking Elizabeth Warren? Because he is, again, they've as you said, they've kind of been in a standoff. Neither one seemed to gain a lot by attacking the other for a while. But now that he's bleeding support, do you think that's going to change?
It's risky. I do think he needs a change in script. But how do you go after Warren? I mean, what do they disagree on? Not many things. I mean, they're on the same page on Medicare for All. And the Medicare for All issue is an interesting one, because Sanders has taken the incoming on that. The politics have changed a bit on Medicare for All, where at first everyone was for Medicare for All, including Kamala Harris. Then all all of a sudden she backs away. Joe Biden's going on the attack. I think it's going to be very difficult for Sanders to do that because it's not his style. But at the same time, he has to do something different. And I think he might have to go after Biden a bit more just to try to get some of the supporters he's lost.
I think Warren is hard to go after for anyone in general. I think it's very hard to attack her on anything of substance that doesn't sound like a right-wing attack, right? We know Trump is going to go after Pocahontas and all that stuff, but Democrats are not going to do that. I would say, you know, as Warren has risen, Sanders has not really fallen.
No.
She has consolidated the support that has gone away from Kamala Harris, that has moved away from Pete Buttigieg, and those people have, by and large, come into her camp, and that's been responsible for her rise in the polls. So I do think some of the media obituary of Bernie Sanders is a little premature here. When you look at the early states and you see he's still in good position in Iowa, in New Hampshire, he's second to Biden in South Carolina. One poll had him first in Nevada, first in California. So I do think there's a little bit of premature media obit being written right here.
I agree. You know, this morning de Blasio dropped out. Bernie Sanders is going to be in this race for a long time. He's got
the
resources.
Who do you think the five de Blasio supporters are going to go to? Sorry.
That's rough. That's
too mean.
But, you know, you're
too
right.
Well,
you mentioned Buttigieg, and yesterday Buttigieg went after Warren, and I think on a decent issue, Medicare for All, because he called her answer on paying for the $32 trillion extremely evasive.
Huh.
But attacks, as you were talking about, on the Democratic side, sometimes, most times, they've actually not worked.
They've backfired on the person
for Trump in 2016,
them.
They worked all the time.
Right.
He went after everybody, went Jeb, Rand Paul, they all worked, basically worked. Democrats, it's a different dynamic. Castro going after Biden's age. Did that work? No, not at all.
No, if anything, we've seen Biden's poll numbers go up after that debate.
Yes, yes. And you know, and I think that had he not had that attack on him, I think more people would have been saying, well, it was kind of an okay debate, maybe a little shaky. But because of that, and I think Biden is smart to take the high road. He didn't really go after, at least personally, go after Castro. He just said, well, he had some wrong information. I think that's smart, especially at the front runner. But they have to be worried about Warren's rise. And because this is becoming kind of a two-person race at this point. I agree. Sanders is going to be in this, and this thing can change. But Harris has just plummeted.
Harris has fallen off.
Harris is in a lot of trouble right now.
Yeah.
What is Warren vulnerable on the hypocrisy charge, right? Because as you mentioned, her platform is very, very similar to Bernie Sanders. But can Bernie Sanders say, I'm the original? Because Elizabeth Warren has changed a lot of her positions over the years, right? Especially on issues, for example, of education. She used to be very much in favor of school choice. She wrote the two-income trap, and a lot of her critiques were similar to Donald Trump's. She hasn't always been as progressive as she's running right now. Is she vulnerable there?
I don't think so, just because Biden has changed his position on so many things, and he's been a bit Teflon. I mean, on many, many issues. He's tried to, and I think he should stop talking about the Iraq War because he voted for the Iraq War, and Hillary Clinton tried that long explanation of it. You voted for the war, Joe. Don't try to go there. But I think because he's changed his opinion so much, and also it is kind of ancient history. People want to look forward, and that's what I think Bernie's right. He wrote most of the platform in 2016. He did come up with Medicare for All at first. He's come up with as far as student loans, his idea. But people need to look forward, not backward.
Mm, yeah. I mean, I think with Warren, too, while some of her individual positions may have shifted, since she has burst onto the national radar, she has had a brand as a progressive.
Yes.
So it feels like she's been consistent, even if within that there have been some changes.
Yes.
Bob, thank you. Great
thank
to
you.
See you.
Thank you.
Former Massachusetts Governor Bill Weld has officially entered the 2020 Republican primary, but not without significant resistance from the GOP establishment.
Governor Weld discusses how he plans to overcome those roadblocks and more next.